many things that God has given me. Signs and wonders, what were for? Those were worthy of the fruit. Though your God is worthy, like a tree planted by the rivers of water, you blow them like no other. Benson, Idahosa, the icon you were still on.
You see, one thing about Papa Idahosa, he loved God and he loved evangelism.
Idahosa is a man that believes with God all things are possible. He had an unwavering faith.
Spiritual a person, yet he was so human in nature. A man who reached out to everyone, the high and the low in society. A man who rubbed shoulders with presidents and the highest of dignitaries you can think of in society.
The man brought me out from the dungeon.
Papa Idahosa was, he was a man full of energy and vision.
I was a Muslim that I gave my life to Christ. In Ghana, there was this kind of freedom of worship. There were a lot of Muslims. And among those people that were the grace of God, I gave my life to Christ. And I wanted to go to Bible school when I felt the call of God upon my life. And unfortunately for me, at that particular time with the Assemblies of God Ghana, there was no space for women to go to Bible school. So my pastor called me and said, he wants me to go to Nigeria and meet with Idahosa because there is a room in that particular ministry for women. And I traveled to Nigeria by the grace of God. I'm getting there. I met with the Archbishop, my first time of meeting the Archbishop in Idahosa of Church of God Mission International.
What an awesome privilege it was to see this man of faith and boldness. I will never forget the Onitsha Crusade. At that time, the head of state in Nigeria had passed a law that nobody should do open air crusades. And Archbishop said he went to pray and said, God, what they are saying, and God asked him, what do you want? He said, I want to do crusade. God said, go ahead and do your crusade. So he sent us, I was part of the advance team, to go and paste posters all over Onitsha. And we went to put posters all over Onitsha. And the first day of the crusade, a truckload of soldiers came. And Archbishop mounted the platform. And the soldiers came with their guns. When Archbishop started preaching, they all put their guns down. When he made the altar call, they all raised their hands to receive Jesus as Lord and personal Savior.
We traveled to Washington for Jesus. John Gemenes went to Baltimore, flew to New York, and then flew to Lagos on Nigeria with 11 hours. And then we took Okada Air from Lagos to Benin City. It was bad weather. Brother, it was one turbulence. I told God, as long as I'm alive, never let me face anything like this again in my travel. Archbishop Idahosa and the wife Margaret were in the first class, which is only divided by a curtain because it's a 90-seater plane. And we took off from Lagos to Benin. It was bad weather, raining cats and dogs. We entered a storm. There were Filipino pilots. And then they said that he has lost contact. The pilot said, listen, he has lost contact with Lagos. And so he doesn't know where he is. That is ridiculous. You are supposed to be taking us to Benin. So if you, the pilot, has lost contact and you don't know where you are, and it's raining cats and dogs. What do you want us to do? And when I looked through the window, brother, I was sitting at the edge of my seat like this. I was shaking in my boots. I've never been scared like that. I thought it was a life and death situation. The plane will move, dive, turn left, turn right. When I looked through the curtain, I was looking at the reaction of the Archbishop Idahosa. He said, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. And then one time, he stood up in the aircraft. He lifted his hand. I will never forget. He said, God, this is what he said. God, you called me and you didn't say I would die in a plane crash. My mission is not finished. My assignment is not over. We call the enemy to order and command the devil to back off. Now you pilot, you better find out where you are and take us to our destination in the name of Jesus. And he sat down. 5 minutes time, the pilot said, he has made contact with Port Harcourt. Listen to this. We are supposed to be doing 30 minutes from Lagos to Benin. And the pilot, we landed in Port Harcourt. So we have lost our way. We would have ended up in the sea. I will never forget. We landed in Lagos. It was still raining. That is where the testimony is. Mama Idahosa was there. You can ask her. I told Papa, can I please go for bus? Because I was afraid. Can we get a bus so we go to Benin? He said, no. James, you don't travel like I do. I must conquer the devil today in the air. I said, what is this? I was scared. I said, Papa, you want us to die? He said, James, if I don't conquer the devil, I will not be able to travel by air. Okada gave us a gold-plated aircraft. When he called him, the plane rolled out from the hangar, and we went by air to Benin. And that Sunday evening, he made me go to church and give a testimony. He's a Ghana boy. He calls me Ghana boy. I came and said, give them your testimony, you coward. he never celebrated mediocrity.
New job, new prosperity,
your prosperity,
new miracle,
new joy,
new